In this lesson, you will learn how to export requirements in a documented format. So let's go into the requirements module and see the current structure. So as you can see here, I have on the left hand side the requirements tree, including the different chapters of my requirements document, like sales and distribution. If I open it, I can see there are sub chapters like track sales orders, sell from stock, sales volume, financial accounting, and so on. And in order for me to export the requirements, I have now few possibilities in ALM Octane. Either I can use one of those two buttons on the requirement header, export to PDF or export to Word. The moment I click on export, you will see it will automatically accept the request and download a PDF file for the whole requirement. Yeah, and this is very nice because now if I open it, I can see all the different requirements description, including screenshots. So it's really like a document I would extract out of Octane. But one thing to consider is that out of the box, you can see you just export the title, you export the ID, and you export the description. So everything which is in the description field will be exported. You are not exporting any additional data, like if I'm here on the management part of the requirement and I go to details, the release information or the priority, the author. So these kind of things are not getting exported. So this is important to know. Additionally, if you want to export those items as well, you can make use of the REST API to extract those items. I'll be recording another video for how to make use of the REST API to use these two buttons. And there's another option. So this was the very first option, how you could export requirements in a document format. The second option is for sure the document report, where you can configure the report to your needs, and also allow it allows to export requirements which you have documented. So let's take a look how this looks like. So here I can really select again the requirement document entity, decide also beside the fields I have in the standard output export. I can also add additional fields. So let's say I add priority here as well. Then I have the description. Let's move priority. Let's move description directly after. Come on, after phase or before phase in this case. I can decide to include attachments if I want. Also change the format, more document-like or table-like. So this is what I can configure here. And on top of the entity, I can add related items like covering tests or last runs. So this is also something which could be very interesting for you to add here, and then configure again these entities separately. Yeah, so here I can add the covering test, including the scripts. So this should be fine. And if I generate the document now, you will see it will be a bit different from the formatting perspective, but you can extract all the requirements using the document report. And once the request is completed, it will automatically start the downloading here. So you can see download has been started and completed. So I can open the document now. In this case it was a Word document, and you can see it has created here the different chapters for everything. But let me scroll down to understand what has been exported. So here the similar things, you can see I have the requirements document, including the ID, I have the name, I have here the description, phase, priority, and attachments, and so on. So this is the way how you can really export requirements into a Word format or into your document format.